Let me ask you, first of all, about the electrification push for Toyota. We were talking about huge numbers for the European car manufacturers, but you have been there, you know, long before anyone else. Is it going to cost you as much to electrify your whole fleet?
Well, you know, we started the electrification of our fleet already 20 years ago with hybrid vehicles. And in Europe now, 50% of our sales is hybrid vehicles. So we're fairly advanced when it comes to electrification. If we look at the targets which has been set in European market for CO2 that we need to achieve, electrification is an absolute requirement for the future. So we will continue investing in not just the hybrid vehicles, but also plug-in hybrid vehicles, battery electric vehicles, and fuel cell vehicles for hydrogen.
What do you think about the hydrogen fuel cell potential? If you look out 5 to 10 years, do you see a mix of alternative powertrains, or do battery vehicles kind of win?
Well, I think there would be a mix. We've started with a portfolio approach 20 years ago already, where we said there will be a hybrid portfolio of technologies which will be utilized, and these technologies will be utilized by the customer to suit their specific need. Therefore, we see a big market for, of course, hybrid vehicles, and that will be our dominant technology into the future still, but then also plug-in vehicles and battery electric vehicles. Hydrogen we still see as a small portion of the market into the future, but long-term, hydrogen, of course, is a very good energy carrier and a solution for the future.
What do you think about the consolidation, or let's say the collaboration that we're seeing amongst automakers? All of a sudden, we've got BMW working with Daimler on car sharing, Volkswagen and Ford working together on autonomous driving. Where does Toyota hope to partner up?
Well, we know we've started many partnerships and alliances within the industry. In Europe, for instance, we've got the alliance with BMW, which we developed a sports car jointly, the new Supra, which has just been announced, but also with PSA, which we have an alliance. We also have an alliance manufacturing facility with them. So alliances are being utilized to develop jointly some of these technologies, which is incredibly expensive to do. And Toyota is also doing that. For instance, on battery electric vehicles, we've started a new company where 11 companies are participating in developing a dedicated battery electric vehicle platform for battery electric vehicles. So alliances is being utilized now, and it's really, really project driven to make sure that we can develop these technologies for the future at a cost-effective way.
Does it help you in trade issues? I mean, trade concerns must be front and center for Toyota, as well as they are for most of the car makers globally. How do you see that getting resolved?
Well, you know, we've always believed as a company that we believe in free trade. So I cannot comment on the USA, what's going to happen there. Of course, we would like to see an outcome where we don't have trade friction. But in Europe, for instance, we are not a big exporter of vehicles. We are supplying mainly the European market. So from that point of view, our biggest concern, of course, is there would be any trade issues between the UK and the European market in future. That will have a big impact on us.
You are still, though, one of the biggest car makers in the world. You've got an incredible leader in Akio Toyota. What can you do to influence the trade discussions? Do you go to Washington and talk directly to President Trump? Do you go here in Brussels and talk to Cecilia Malmström?
Well, of course, our teams in the US and also here in Europe, we are doing what companies normally do to raise the point, to really highlight what would the impact be, and that is the processes we are involved with.
Let me ask you, brought up the Supra, and for gearheads, this is a special car with a special history. Been waiting a long time to see this company, to see this car come back with this company. What kind of demand are you getting?
Well, you know, in Europe, we actually have full subscription of our supply for this year. So the demand is very, very strong. We sold them out before we even have them. And of course, hopefully this trend will continue. It is really a car, as you've said, petrolheads like myself been waiting for. and we see an excellent performance of the car. The car is a very, very good car, and of course, it will be our flagship sports car into the future.